turn 16 is the last of the legato licks, and it just kind of finger slides. Let's play that one for you. Okay. All right. That does it for the legato section. The next section we're going to get into is what I call legato tapping. Okay? Legato tapping to me, like I said, is kind of a... I like to think of it as just pushing your finger onto the strings, pulling them back off, pushing them on, pulling them back off. And it's kind of an extension of legato. Like I said, when I first came across legato, I was trying to actually tap instead of doing the Eddie Van Halen type of tapping. I was actually trying to tap out scales. And just the way I would play scales, I would try to actually find ways to tap them out. And that was my idea of tapping. That's why I call it legato tapping. But it's a cool way, really fun way that you can play. And I try to show you some different things that people haven't shown you quite the same way before. And it's going to be a lot of odd note grouping patterns. Once again, just to take you through the regiment. And let me start out with a fives pattern. Lick number 117 is tapping fives. Okay, that's a tapping five. That's pretty neat. Lick 118 deals with a tapping five, but we do a little bit more of a finger slide with it. Lick number 118. Lick 119 does something even a little bit more different. It jumps string to string. Kind of the same thing, but doing it on a different string. Let's check that out. There we go. Took me a while to get that clean. That's lick number 119. 120 is a tapping sixes riff. Very difficult to do. Just remember that pattern is hard to do. Okay. That's lick number one. It is a pretty difficult tapping riff to do. It's a sixes tapping riff. It's hard to do it without getting string noise. Really challenging. That's why I wanted to show it to you. Really difficult to do to bring up to speed, but it's pretty cool. Work on that one. 122 is a sevens tapping riff. Check this one out. That's pretty neat. Lick 123 is another sevens tapping riff. And okay. Lick 124 is a tapping riff that kind of uses two hits on it. Let me show you that slow. It's a seventh riff. Okay, that's pretty neat. Lick 125 is a tapping nines riff. Let's check that one out. Okay. A 26 is kind of difficult to do, but if you work on it, you can get it. It's a tapping nines lick. You kind of slide along as you're going along. And it looks a lot easier than what it is. It's actually pretty difficult. Lick 127 is an ascending tapping tens, and it kind of gets your fingers simulating the four note per string playing, but without playing four notes per string, you're actually simulating it through tapping. Okay. Lick 128 simulates the same sort of four note per string playing, but using two fingers on each hand. Okay. Lick 129 is kind of a bizarre tapping tens rock lick. Check this out. But 130 is a tapping tens lick. Let's check this out. Okay, lick 131 is kind of a strange tapping tens riff. Check it out. Really challenging, like I said, to keep your string noise down when you're doing these types of riffs. Some people have a string dampening device they put on their guitar, which I've seen one that Michelangelo sells to help you when you're tapping to keep your string noise down to a minimum. Okay,